So now, as you may know, a Tesla Model S just recently did over 300,000 miles.
So why should you care?
Now, a Model S has an 8-year unlimited mileage warranty. And so these people that put over 300,000 miles on this thing only spent a little over 10 grand.
10 grand?
Yeah, 10 grand keeping it on the road.
For 300,000 miles, an electric vehicle went 300,000 miles for 10, that's incredible.
It's insane.
If you were to do a comparable, like, let's say 7 Series or E-Class, it'd probably be an S-Class. Probably S-Class Mercedes. You'd probably, what, for 300,000 miles, let's just say it's roughly $3 per gallon. You'd be doing...
On the low end,
right, yeah. For premium. Yeah, you're probably putting premium, so at least $3 a gallon, and it's probably getting, what, 20 miles a gallon, roughly? You hope?
Yeah, maybe.
Let's say highway miles, yeah. So let's say 20 miles to the gallon, you're roughly paying $45,000 just to run that car for 300,000 miles, not taking into account any maintenance or service intervals, which, I mean, it could be, what, $80,000 or $90,000 just to keep that car on the road.
I mean, a Mercedes oil change is like $300, right?
Well, that's why I have him.
So yeah, just quick napkin math. I mean, around $40,000-$45,000 in fuel, probably another $40,000-$50,000 in maintenance and repairs, and it's gonna cost you $100,000 on top of the $100,000 you spent to buy the thing to do 300,000 miles.
Jesus. Okay, well, that is not the same thing with an electronic vehicle. Now Model S's have a range of about 265 miles. So if you were to do the math, you get roughly 1,100, 1,200 total charges on that car to do 300,000 miles. With that, the battery is still at over 90% of full life. What's really interesting about that is there was these guys in Europe that did tests on the first 50,000 miles and then the next 150,000 miles to see how much battery life actually was lost in the initial 50K and 150. And believe it or not, this battery, it was replaced at, what, 200,000 miles?
They replaced it at 200,000 miles, but not because the battery itself was actually worn out. It was because of a firmware problem in the battery unit and they hadn't released new software.
Yeah, so, well, you know, there's always a first, right? With that said, if you were to do this 300,000 miles with the original battery, you'd still probably be 80-85% of full battery life with still 6 years and unlimited mile warranty. Now that is killer. So what's really cool is, as you can take a look at these graphs with the 50K and the 150K, these batteries hold their charge way better than a phone or a laptop.
Compared to something like an iPhone, where the battery starts showing its age after only like a year.
That's because you're so popular. Jeez.
And conveniently, the warranty's expired around then as well. So it seems then like a Model S is an awesome value. It's not a cheap car, but it's a great value, especially if you want it.
But there's a few things that the Model S doesn't give you the convenience of a gas engine. And that is, what if you're low on battery and you have somewhere to be? You have to sit there and charge it. Usually that means that you have to walk to your local Starbucks and spend like $7 on a latte, or like just sit there and wait for your car to charge. Mm-hmm. With the gasoline engine, you literally go to the pump, stick it in, wait 2 minutes, take it out, and you're done.
Right, but they are working on these superchargers, you know what I mean? They're getting quicker. You can charge it to almost 100% in like less
than an hour. But you have to be at a place that has a supercharger.
That's true.
With that said though, the depreciation on a car that has an unlimited warranty for miles, as well as just everything that breaks other than like tires
full
and brakes.
Full warranty for 8 years, everything on the car.
That car isn't gonna depreciate nearly as much as an S-Class or a 7 Series. So with that, you probably lost like 3/4 of the depreciation with an S-Class after 2 years. There probably isn't one out there, but I'm guessing it's gonna be over half of the initial investment in the car, where with the Model S, you're probably looking at 20-30%.
Yeah.
So yes, the initial investment is more, but you also get more out after 2 years and 300,000 miles.
Well, Brad, and on top of all that, any gasoline engine with 300,000 miles on it is going to start to show its age. Maybe not so much diesels, but definitely gasoline engines.
Right.
Whereas an electric motor, even with 300,000 miles on it, they pretty much output the same amount they did when they were brand new up until the day they flat out die. And if you're driving this thing that much, it'll be replaced under warranty anyway.
Wait, so why does my battery after 1 year wear out and not run as fast? Or wait, that's probably a software issue, not battery.
All right, guys, Thanks for watching.
Well, and please remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel because we have great content coming out, and I think we have a lot of good content that already came out. So check that out. Also, please like us
on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter at Ideal Cars TV.
Oh yeah, and tap that like button. Ciao.
We'll see you next time.